trees are there, B trees, B plus trees, right? So what is the advantage of those trees? There are many advantages and disadvantages. So one can be improved in other tree. So you should be very sure about what are the plus and what are the minus of those individual applications and individual cases. Now, here this optimal binary search tree, when I say, actually the number of comparison what we are doing in the binary search tree, that matters. So one thing is, like I have given the number 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, when I give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, if I straight away draw the tree for that, root will be 1. Since 2 is larger, it goes to right, 2 will come to the right side. Then 3 is picked, 3 is larger than 1, it goes to right. 3 is larger than 2, it goes to right. So you'll be getting 3, node 3 over there. Then node 4, 4 is larger than 1, goes to right. 4 is larger than 2, goes to right. 4 is larger than 3, goes to right, and I'll get the node over here. So you will be getting a one-sided tree. Correct, no? So one-sided. So it is not balanced tree. So what is the disadvantage of that unbalanced tree? So if it is unbalanced tree, I won't be able to get the actual benefit of that tree. So what is the actual benefit of the tree? I will reduce the number of comparison when I try to retrieve the data. So otherwise, there is no difference between sequential storage and tree storage. So whatever the tree just now I have discussed, it is similar to your sequential. If I want to search the element, I have to start from the root and I have to go till the leaf is reached. So automatically, it's of no use. So the something like that. So those balancing is required. So now here, the concept is like, see, that time I have told, this is what we call. In this fashion, if I get the tree, it's of no use. So that I want to avoid. So now there are many alternate combination you'll get. All the combination, if you start trying, it is growing like exponential. Since we have only 4 nodes over here, you can try with all the possible cases, and whichever will give the best result, that you can choose. But my intention is, if I have some kind of algorithm to do the task, then it is easy for us to pick the optimal result among whatever the alternate results are available. So this is how the optimal binary search tree concept is defined. Now, for that optimal binary search tree, I'll just get into the problem. So you can straight away look into the problem, and later you can find it out how exactly the procedure is continued. And meanwhile, you'll be able to understand the algorithm also. I didn't touch any of the algorithm, only the procedure I'll be explaining. So the indices, they have represented 1 to 4, and the key elements A to D they have given, and the kind of probability. Probability means how frequently those characters are being used or retrieved. So accordingly, if I place or accordingly, if I put that in the tree, it will be beneficial. So the probability was given. So using that probability, how I can calculate the binary search tree? So for that, this formula is being used. C of ij, those are the table entries. This is something like how many elements are there, those many element plus one extra row over here. It starts from 1 to that. The columns are starting from 0 to 4. So what is the number of elements present? That many columns you need to specify. Now, initially the diagonal elements are made 0. Then I have to calculate each of these values. C of 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Those values I need to calculate. So initial value is what you know. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. They are all these probability what you have given, that only we need to calculate, or that only we need to add. Then in the next iteration, C of 1,2 need to be calculated. 1,2, if it is calculated, in turn you have to calculate the k varies from I to j. I to j means 1,2, I have told. So 1 to 2 means 1 and 2, two options are there. So C of 1, k minus 1, k is if you have taken 1, so it will be 1 minus 1, 0. C of 1, 0. C of 1, k is taken as 1, 1 plus 1 is 2. 2, comma, j is 2, 2, comma, 2. So like that, you will be use this formula and try to fill up all these values. So C of 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 4. So once you have done with that, we'll be able to calculate C of 1, 3 and 2, 4. But every time it uses the previous value, so are being calculated. So try to remember that formula and try to calculate those individual values. So as a result, this is the entire table. Actually, multiple values will be there. So among those multiple values, whichever is the least value, I need to consider and I'll put it into the table. So once I have done with that table, there is one more table we need to construct. That table is called as a root table. So root table is what, you know, when you are calculating, we are calculating one of the value here. C of 1, 2, this is the value I have written. So then your k will vary from I to j. So k can be equal to 1 as well as k can be equal to 2. So 1 and 2 I have taken. So if it is 1, C of 1, 0, it is according to the formula. It is C of 1, 1, plus C of 3, 2. So this, you among these two values, whichever is giving the least value, that I need to consider for calculating the minimum value. So here the first part will calculate 0.2 and the second value will give 0.1. Among these two values, 0.1 is the minimum. So 0.1 plus 0.3 will become 0.4. That time you need to remember, like, I have taken the value from the second row. So second row was for the value, which k value it is 2. So that 2 need to be saved in this root table. Okay, that 2 is saved in this root table. Like that, for all the other entries, whatever you have calculated, make sure that which minimum value you have taken, and for that minimum value, which is the k value, that has to be mentioned over here. So then automatically, I'll try to construct the binary search tree. Binary search tree, this 1.7, whatever they got it over here, that will give the least value of the overall comparison, what we need to do when the corresponding tree is being constructed. So that is the benefit. But now from this table, how do we get this tree, that I want to identify. So initially I have to go, there are four elements, 1, 4 I need to verify. So 1, 4, that entry is there I have the value 3. So when the value 3 indicates what, you know, in the sequence, third character will become the root node. Okay, so 1, 4, the value is 3. Sorry, the value is 3, that indicates that the third node is the root node. Okay, if the third node is root node, what is left out? In the right side, one node is left out, and in the left side, two more nodes are left out. Okay, so right side, it starts from a fourth node. So fourth node to only one node is there. So 4, 4, I have to check. 4, 4 is 4 only. So root for right child is fourth node itself. So automatically right child, I'll make it as a D. Now for C, left side, there are two nodes available. So among these two nodes, which is the root node I want to identify? So these two nodes start from 1 onwards, correct? No, 1, 2, up to 2 nodes are there. It is 1 to 2. So that's why 1, 2 I need to verify. So 1, 2, what is the value I have? That is 2 again. So automatically I'll get to know that the second node is the root node. So for C, the left child will become B. Now, once that subset and only two values, A and B. Among that, B has become the root for that subtree. Now, what is left out? Only left side one element is left out. So that is one element only. It starts from one and ends with one only. So 1, 1 I have to check. 1, 1 is one. So the first node itself becomes the node for that left out element. So as a result, we come to the left side of that B. So this is how this tree is being constructed. So the table are helpful to get the tree, optimal binary search tree. So optimal they have used because the number of comparison should reduce. So otherwise you will be, you can end up with a lot many trees over there. Okay. Then there is one more concept, a knapsack problem. So in the previous technique also we were discussing about this knapsack problem. So you know the concept. Now the concept when I want to work out to get the solution, like the tabular method I want to use because it is a knapsack algorithm. Dynamic algorithm. So when it is the dynamic programming application is applied for that, this is a formula, recursive formula they are using for the sake of calculation. The profit has to be maximized. So what kind of profit we need to calculate? It is something like f of I comma j value need to be calculated. How do we calculate that? It is with respect to the previous vertex. So the previous entry, f of I minus 1 comma j, it can be the previous value. So f of I minus 1 comma j means here j is the total weight, intermediate weight they are talking about. And this side it is the element they are talking. So I minus 1 comma j only if I write, that indicates that we didn't consider the element. Okay, the current element is the current profit is the same as the previous profit, then the current element is not being considered. So what I supposed to do, then no need to add the profit of current element. Or I can have one more possibility. I'll get the previous iteration. In the previous iteration, the actual J value was somewhat lesser than W of I, because the current J, whatever I'm talking about, I'll assume that after considering that element, I got that J value. Then, of course, the previous weight should be J minus WI value. So these are the two scenarios. But if this is the case, then ith element you have considered, for that sake, I have to add the profit of that ith element or value of that ith element. So that is given by V of I. So among these two values, like it is something like by considering ith element I'll be proceeding, or by rejecting the ith element I'll be proceeding. So in both way I'll be getting some profit. Whichever profit is larger, that you need to consider. So maximum among these two you have considered. Or else when there is a scenario like J minus WI should be greater than or equal to zero, means the current element, when you are subtracting the weight of that element, so the positive value you should get, then only it is true. If you are getting negative value, means automatically that ith element can be directly rejected. So that time it is only f of I minus 1 comma j. So these are the two scenarios with respect to the current weight and current capacity and the weight of individual items, so that they are calculating. So similarly, I can draw the table in this fashion. So they have given the problems like problem definition with respect to the knapsack problem. There are four elements with the weights 2, 1, 3, 2 and the corresponding profit or value 12, 10, 20, and 15. So I will make the table like this. So in the table, what do I do? The capacity was 5 they have given. So starting from 0 capacity up to 5, I have to note it down. Then how many elements? 4 elements. Starting with the no element till the 4th element, I have to write. Then the just in front of or just left to those individual items, please note down the weight and values, so that helps you to do the entries later in the table. So W1 V1, W2 V2, W3 V3, like that. So initially what I supposed to do is, like, zeroth row and zeroth column can be filled with the zero. Okay, zeroth row and zeroth column can be filled with zero. Now I have to calculate 1, 1. So 1, 1, if I want to calculate, I can apply this what you call formula, and I can get it done. So these values are being calculated. So again, I won't discuss how those values are calculated. Just apply the values to these formula. So you'll get the actual result. So finally, 4, 5, this is the entry where I will get the exact value, means the total profit gained that I will be getting. So this will be the optimal profit what I have gained. So now, which are the elements considered? So I will come see 37 and the previous row value in the same column, I have to check 37 and 32. So are they equal? It is not equal. If it is not equal, then fourth element is considered. Okay, fourth element is included. Now, what is the 32? The fourth element, weight, profit. Okay, so it is something like 4, 5, that value need to be considered. Okay, so now 4, 5 and 3, 5, those are the two values we need to consider. But in that case, if it is not equal, that element is considered, and if it is equal, it indicates like that element is not considered, means the element is not at all considered. Why the equal condition will arise? When it will arise? If the element is rejected. So when element is rejected, profit is not added. So then the previous profit, whatever I had, same thing will be continued to the next level. So that is the backtracking method applied for finding the which are the elements considered for the next for the subset. Okay, so that same procedure will be continued for the all the levels. So finally, I'll get to know that which are the elements are considered under what you call subset sum problem. Okay, not subset sum, knapsack problem. Now, the algorithm whatever I have discussed here, this table is fully calculated, in the sense all the entries in the table were calculated. So most of the values may not be used to get the optimal solution. Okay, most of the values may not be used for getting the optimal solution. So for that sake, they have come up with one more algorithm called what you call memory function. Okay, so the memory function. So using knapsack problem, using dynamic programming only, but it is a memory function concept is being used. So if I use that memory function concept, then unwanted calculations can be avoided. Okay, unwanted calculation can be avoided. So only few entries in the table are calculated. So finally, I'll come up with the optimal solution only. So only the procedure is a little modified so that the rest of the entries can be avoided, rest of the calculation can be avoided. So again, you can go through that concept. So that is related to what you call the knapsack problem. So next, we have a single source shortest path algorithm. As we discussed in the previous technique, there also single source shortest path algorithm we have discussed, that was Distress algorithm. But Distress algorithm works only when there are if it is having only the positive edges, edge cost. Okay, so only if the edge costs are positive, then only the distress algorithm work. If there is any negative cause, then I can't apply distress algorithm for that graph. So that time I need to go for another alternate algorithm. That is what we call it as the Bellman-Ford algorithm. Okay. So how this Bellman-Ford algorithm works? So this is again the dynamic programming approach only. We'll be calculating in each iteration what are the values we are going to get. But again, Bellman-Ford algorithm also fails sometimes for some of the graph. So what is that graph? The negative cycle, if it is present. Negative cycle means, see, I may say I'll be having one cycle here. No cycle. Yeah. No. Fine. So in this, I don't have any cycle. Suppose if this direction was towards this side, then if I have all the negative values for all those edges, so then I'll be getting one cycle like this. Means whatever the distance I have, minus one will be the distance for this. Whatever the distance I have, minus one for the minus one, if it is negative, minus one. So minus one will be the distance for this. Then whatever the distance I had, minus two will be the distance for this. Now in one iteration, you had initially assumed that all are the zeros. So zero minus one, it will become one, minus one. Minus one, minus one, it will become minus two. Minus two, minus two, it becomes minus four. Now in the next iteration, what happens? Minus four, minus one, it becomes minus five. So how many iteration you perform, that many time the values get reduces. So that should not happen. Otherwise, I can't terminate my program or I can't terminate the procedure. So if there is a negative cycle, then Bellman-Ford will fail to give the answer. So I have to make sure that there is no cycle. Okay, now in this graph, there is no cycle. Some edges are denoted with the negative sign and some are positive sign. So now the initial step is what you know. I'll be calculating, it is a single source shortest path. So source has to be defined. Correct. So from that source, for all other vertices, we can calculate the what you call distance. Now source is one, so dist of one is reaching that node is zero only. And dist of two is one to two, it is six. Dist of three is nothing but one to three, it is five. Dist of four is nothing but one to five, it is five. 1 to 4, it is 5. Dist of 5 is nothing but 1 to 5. I don't have direct connectivity, so I made it infinity. Rest of the values are infinity. So in the first iteration, 0, 6, 5, 5, infinity, infinity, I'll calculate. Now, in the next iteration, the distance for this remains the same, okay? And the rest of the entries I need to update. 6, 5, that was the value we got it from the direct connectivity from the confirmed vertex. So initially 0, node 1 is confirmed. Okay, among these values, whichever is the minimum value that you need to consider. So how I will be making sure, but for that sake, what we are doing here is we will perform the iteration like for all the nodes, how many connectivities are there. From that connectivity, we'll try to get the new distance. So with if I consider the node 2 only, it is connected from 1 as well as it is connected from 3. So if it is connected from what you call 1, it is a distance from distance of 1 plus 6. Distance of 1 is a 0. 0 plus 6 will be 6 only. If it is connected from 3, then for the distance 3, the previous value was 5 in the previous iteration. It is 5. So 5 and towards 2, the edge cost minus 2. So 5 minus 2 will become 3. So if it is lesser, the 3 and 6, whichever is lesser, that I will place it over here. So I'll update the value in this iteration. So like that, it is updated for all other nodes, for 3 also. If it is connected directly from 1, it is 5. If it is connected via 4, up to 4, it is 5. 5 minus, for 4, it is 5. So 5 minus 2 will become 3. So I can update the value of that also 3. So like that, you do this iteration. There are how many vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 vertices are there. So you can iterate it for 6 iteration. Then you can stop the process. So like in the last iteration, whatever the value you'll get, that will be the minimum distance with respect to node 1. So this is the kind of calculation we are performing. So again, the procedure is like the previous entries are used to calculate the next level values. Only thing is that node from where and all it is connected, that you should be aware of. And the procedure is like a common path you need to find it out. Same procedure you need to apply when you are calculating the current value. And current value, these updated value should not be used for calculating the same level values. Like when I want to calculate the value for node 5, if it is connected from 2, now the 2 value distance was updated to 3. So don't consider that updated value, rather you choose the previous value only. So this is how the Bellman-Ford program works. Next is the traveling salesman problem. Traveling salesman problem also was discussed in the previous technique. In that technique also, it is the kind like we need to have that branch and bound technique, and recursive method was being discussed. Now it is a dynamic programming concept. So in case of dynamic programming, it is almost little bit of similar to your multi-stage graph only. So we are verifying from one stage to the next available stage. It is like, if the from node 1, I want to travel all the cities and come back to 1. That time, if I start from 1, what is the possible cities he can visit in the next level? It is only 2 and 4. So that is not 2 and 4. It can be 2, 3 or 4. All are connected to 1. So you need to choose among those vertices. So one way I'll consider with respect to 2 and I'll proceed. One thing I'll consider with respect to 3 and I'll proceed. One side I'll proceed with respect to 4, consider 4 and proceed. So again, among these values, whichever is the minimum value, that has to be taken and use the formula, whatever they have discussed here. So using that formula, you'll be going to get the result. So.